North Valley Kids. It's me, Pastor Brian, and I'm so excited to be with you guys today. In just a little bit, we're going to be getting into the Bible and looking at the importance of the gospel, the story, the good news about Jesus. But before we get into that, I have a question for you. Which do you like better, good news or bad news? If you had to choose, which one would you choose? Let's take just a minute and answer that question. All right, well, I know for me, yeah, if I have to choose between good news or bad news, of course I'm going to choose good news. Bad news is never fun to hear. Well, in today's story, we're going to see how important and how good the news was of Jesus and how the disciples had to share it everywhere to everyone. All right, well, before we do that, though, let's sing these songs together.
Light up. I'm gonna let it shine. And in the dark.
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed singing those songs. And now let's get into our story. So as we know, as the disciples continued to grow in boldness, as they continued to go out and teach, the important message that they shared was called the gospel. And maybe you're wondering, what? I've heard that word before, but I'm not really sure what it means. The gospel simply just means the good news. And the good news is the story of how God sent his son Jesus to this world. So as you guys may know, we've talked about it before, the story of the Bible is all about how God created man and woman to be in a relationship with him. But in the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve sinned, and because of that, there was a separation. But God promised that one day he would do something to bring us back together. And that plan was to send his son, Jesus, to this world to become the sacrifice for our sin, to take the penalty that we deserve because of our sin upon himself, defeating it, conquering it, and then making it so we can be in right relationship with him again. That is the good news. And it's a great story because, you know, it shows how much God loves us. You know, you guys may know the Bible verse, John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the story. That's what the gospel, that's what the Bible is all about. So why don't we go ahead and watch this quick video that's going to tell us a little bit more about this story.
Jesus' followers in the early church wanted everyone to hear the good news about Jesus. God had kept his promise to send a savior. He sent his own son, Jesus, to earth to rescue sinners. Jesus lived the perfect life we cannot live and died the death we deserve to die. On the third day, God raised Jesus from the dead. This good news, the gospel, changes everything. People who love Jesus tell others about him. That's what Paul did. Paul wrote a letter to believers in Rome to tell them that Jesus was the Savior they had been waiting for. Paul wrote, "I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes. Everyone sins and needs to be rescued. God saves people who believe the good news about Jesus. Because of their faith, God forgives their sins and gives them eternal life." Paul wrote that God showed his love for us by sending his son to die for us. We were sinners, enemies of God, but Jesus died and rose again to make us right with God. Jesus is God's good gift to us. Let's rejoice. Paul reminded the people about the first man, Adam. When Adam sinned, death came into the world. Everyone sinned, so death spread to all people. God sent Jesus into the world to bring us a gift that is greater than Adam's sin. Adam brought death, but Jesus brings life. Adam disobeyed God, but Jesus obeyed him perfectly. Does that mean we can keep on sinning because we are forgiven? Paul said no. Jesus sets us free from sin so we can live in a new way that honors him. Because God created everything, he is in charge of everything. Everyone sins or disobeys God. Our sin separates us from God. The good news of the gospel is that God sent his son Jesus to take the punishment we deserve. Everyone who trusts in Jesus will be saved.
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and just seeing how important the gospel really is and how we shouldn't keep it to ourselves, but really, we should go out and share it. Well, on that note, let's go ahead and take a look at this questions from kids.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Today, Faith from Edgewater, Colorado asks,
are there really people in the world who have never heard about Jesus?
Faith, that is a fantastic question. You know, some of us have grown up in places maybe where there are churches all over the place. Maybe we grew up in the church always hearing about Jesus, and so it's surprising to think that some people may have never in their lives heard about Jesus, but the big answer is that's the case. There are some people in this world who have never heard about Jesus. You know, in today's Bible story, we heard that the good news that God sent Jesus into the world to rescue sinners is available for everybody. And there are over 7.6 billion people in the world today. That's a lot of people. But hear this, more than 40% of that, so almost half of those people, live in people groups that we would consider to be called unreached. It means that there are only a small, very small number of people in that group that have heard about Jesus or follow Jesus. So there are many, many people who have never heard about Jesus. But there are also many, many people who have heard about Jesus but do not have trusted in Jesus. So we need to think about both. We need to focus on both and love and care about both. We need to send missionaries to remote places where they've never heard about Jesus so they have the chance to hear about him for the first time. But also we need to live on mission here where we live, where there are people all around us who have heard about Jesus but never trusted in Jesus, because we need to show the love of Jesus to these people. We need to tell them about Jesus. We need to do both, because we want them not only to hear about Jesus but to trust in him so that they can be forgiven their sin and have eternal life with God like we have. So here's a question back for you. What makes you excited or maybe hesitant to share your faith with others?
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed that Questions from Kids and seeing that, yeah, there are people around the world that still need to know and understand who Jesus is. And so I think that is a challenge, right? Like, how do we go and tell others about Jesus? But let's take a second and just answer this question first. What makes you excited or hesitant to share about Jesus? Take just a minute and answer that question. All right, well, I hope you guys had a chance to answer that. You know, I think sometimes just the unknown, right? We don't know what other people are going to think. We don't know what other people are going to say. And so we get a little bit nervous or unsure of ourselves. But the more we practice, the more we get good at just building relationships with people and then sharing with them the good news, the story of Jesus, the more that fear and hesitation, I think, goes away and the more excited we become. All right, well, now let's just go ahead and take a look at our big picture question. Our big picture question for today is, what is the church? The church is all Christians everywhere who gather together in their communities to worship and serve God. Yeah, so when we come together as the church, when we gather in communities and talk about Jesus, that is what the church is all about. It's not a building. It's just believers getting together to worship God. And the good news is there's actually churches all over the world. But then together, because we're all followers of Jesus, we're also one big church, which is kind of cool. All right. And now let's take a look at the memory verse. Our memory verse for today is Romans 12:5. We who are many are one body in Christ and individually members of one another. So even though we're all individual people, when we come together, we become the church, the body of Christ. And it's the body, the hands, the feet that go and do the work that we're supposed to do in sharing and spreading the good news. All right, well, now let's sing this song to help us remember the verse. Whoa.
We who are many are one body in Christ. We who are many.
All right. Well, hope you guys enjoyed singing that song and getting this verse memorized. Before you go, I just want to pray with you guys real quick. Jesus, I thank you for my friends. I thank you that you help us and have given us a new life through your son, Jesus. I pray that you would help us to remember the good news about Jesus and not be quick to keep it to ourselves, but that we would share it with others. We love you, God. We thank you. We ask for your help. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Well, you guys, don't be afraid to share the good news. That's what we're here for. We're here to share and show the love of Jesus to everyone that we can. All right. Until next week, love you guys. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.